Everybody be welcome to sing along. Amen. tom, že budeme čistovat, já to potřebujeme pár hodinu, proto to bude nám více, to říkáš. Jitka dátovi, která nejmává.
Please feel free to touch it to our audio prayer book if you like, and kiss it, if you pray with me. Oh. Vayvahara kotaham rohi A rok odchází, no ale je hodně velkou, a že nějaká máme to hodně, ne? To chají jenom na to, co se jim a rok odchází, a na tým na to hodně.
Knowledge.
But at the end of the portion, after many a generation, God felt, and I quote, heartfelt sadness at the life he created. He felt like everything he created was evil, and he should have never started it. I think it's interesting, because God has such human emotions. Perfect God has regrets. He's regretting everything he made. He's regretting all things. And he looked on the bed on the sixth day, and things were very good. So now, not just good, work, okay. Now he says, I will walk out through the earth. Humans together with beasts, creatures, things, and birds of the sky. For I regret that I made them. As an artist, I can somewhat relate to God here. You feel like everything is going great, and nothing is going wrong. Then you start drawing the hands, or you look at it later, and you feel like it's bored. So you want to tear it out of your attention so that nothing could go on with ugly art. In art school, when I make paintings and let you just throw it away, my teacher comes up to me and says that it's good, and that I can keep working on it. It doesn't feel real, it just doesn't exist. But God listens to the voice and says, your art is okay, keep working, it's okay. And the kind of thing gives me a second chance. I know I probably won't always be able to, but I hope to also listen to the positive hope of exploring the future. My Bat Mitzvah project hopes to raise money for a class in the renowned space station. Commemorating Jews, we use that space station to travel to France. This is a personal project for me because I had ancestors who died in the whole world. We were on a mission called my Mitzvah, it's from my great grandfather and myself. Created food for it in our labor. My dad, his brother, and his brother-in-law all worked at their plant, and my cousin worked in the bar for 5 years. I think he was surprised when our meals growth and his descendants are using that book to celebrate Jewish tradition. My great-grandfather probably couldn't openly tell them the Jews are in their labor. He told him to try to keep the problem of race and keep it from secrets. Maybe after dark, he managed to get something with an apron and a knife. My great grandmother, Hannah, was just a few years older than me when she started living alone on the street after her family had been killed. One time she was arrested, she moved to the police station. She decided she didn't want to die with a hole in her mouth, so she started fixing them. The police officer saw her, and they gave her their time. In the end, they let her go. They let her go, say thank you. Another time, a police officer caught her and he spoke to shoot her, and he pretended to keep it her so she could run away. Bravery is required in the story. The police officer not shooting to my great-grandmother who lived in a severely punished if anyone found out. My great-grandma was driving the entire war in her own vicinity. Being in the middle of all the people who was called life in the darkness. This synagogue has not been they would destroy themselves, and they plan to take everything here from disrespectful and say about their distinct religion, kind of like designed for museums or for Jews. After World War II, this synagogue was used as a storehouse for local business.
coming. Thank you all very much for coming. And we want to thank our family, you guys, who have worked so hard to be here. So many, they loved us so much, that we live so far from our community, and that you're here, and that we're surrounded by people we love, and that we're surrounded by our community here in the Czech Republic, our Jewish community, and our community in our village, that we have, we truly, truly appreciate it. And we want to especially thank the Dolní Konice Synagogue for being so welcoming, and for maintaining such a beautiful building, and for treating us with respect and love, and for having the bravery and kindness to love to be here. Everybody says that Dolní Konice has special air, that there's a special spirit in the air of Dolní Konice. And the moment I walked in this morning, I felt it. And I felt that peaceful goodness, that light in the air. And I want to thank everybody. When Nita was still in my belly, in the womb, I remember she would kick me and my belly would go like this. Like even in the womb, I knew that she was strong and I knew that she was stubborn. And it was like nothing I saw with my other pregnancy actually. Like she, I felt her determination even from the womb. And when she was born, we gave her the name Nita. Nita in Hebrew means flower bud. But it's like a flower bud that has it quite open, which is when the flower bud is the strongest. And Nita's always lived up to that. She's lived up to this growing sense. So much potential and strength and beauty. And we've been watching her bloom for the last 12 years, and it's been the greatest honor. Nita, when she was a toddler, we called her Genghis Khan. Because when we were out of public, Nita would charge ahead as if she was in front of an army. She would charge across the room or out through the park. And she always looked like she was somewhere important to me. She always seemed important, even as a toddler. In her lifetime, Nita has taken on two school systems. We speak English at home, but in Israel, she took on a Hebrew school system. And she was great in Israeli schools. And she learned to speak Hebrew beautifully. And she mastered her class there. And then Republic where we can't even help her with the language at all because within a month she spoke better than we did. And she's surviving in the Czech school system, she's thriving, and we're so proud of her. At every step she is independent and finds her way, and sometimes she thinks she knows, but we don't even fully appreciate her because she's made so many things easy for us by being such a brave and intelligent and kind girl. Nita just started middle school. And she's working hard to navigate a new school system. And one thing, in middle school especially, and in every school here in the Czech Republic, Nita has been an ambassador for Judaism because she's the only Jewish child in her school. Just a few weeks ago, she gave a whole PowerPoint presentation to her class, in middle school, her civics class, about Jewish traditions, and even about the Jewish traditions of our area. And with help class, I'm sorry. But it was about the Jewish traditions of our area. She explained the holidays. I'm so proud that Nita is caring for the traditions of our people. Even though we live in an area where we are the only Jews, luckily we have a wonderful Brno synagogue nearby. But I'm so proud that Nita is caring for these traditions. And watching her today and her bat mitzvah is amazing. It's such a beautiful continuation of that. So who is Nita today? Nita is a creative force. She's constantly getting new ideas and putting them to action, sometimes before we know about it. She's always building things, creating things, designing things, making her own decisions. And she's always, I think creativity is kind of at the heart of who Nita is as a person. She's intelligent, constantly impressing us with her insights and understanding. She's mature, she's taking buses on her own to school, to art school, and making things easier for her family by taking care of herself. And she's kind and warm. Her friends gravitate towards her, and she brings fun and warmth to every interaction. She has a wonderful sense of humor. And she's somebody I enjoy talking to, and who keeps teaching me about the world. And she really loves the way I've learned to use TikTok slang. And she really loves it when I speak in Czech. That's her favorite. She is growing up. She's truly embodying the meaning of her bat mitzvah. This past week, as you all know, we've had horrible news. We've had horrible news from Israel. And it's been just one week, it feels like the world has changed. And it feels like so much has been lost. Nita has a friend in Israel who had her birthday. It was one day after Nita was supposed to have her bat mitzvah today. And days before, not weeks. And I talked to her mother, and her father is newly preserved, and her buttons was canceled. So this week has been a feeling of great sadness leading up to this buttons club. But as Nisa said in her beautiful card for us, it's also a light in the darkness. And this is a beautiful thing in the darkness. This is joy, and this is sorrow. And Nisa is bringing this light in the midst of the darkness of this week. And you are all bringing that light in the midst of the darkness of this week by having the bravery to be here with us today and to celebrate with us. And Nisa, my blessing for you is that you may always continue to be a force for good and light. At every step you try running ahead of us, I hope you can continue to shine, continue to bloom, continue to be yourself. Yes. We're so proud.
This is how it is. If I read, oh, if you want, you can join me, either loud or in heart, repeating my words. We all wish you the best in your day of celebration and for life. Yivarech et Adonai Yishmarech, Ya'er Adonai Panav Elai V'Yikunech, Yisa Adonai Panav Elai V'Yikulchem, V'Yikulchem, V'Yud, Shalom, V'Simcha.
Amen.
Yeah.
But to keep it simple. budou požehnána našim předkům Abrahamovi, Jitzkakovi a Jakobovi a našim pravnukům Sandrovi, která se vedli, požehná a sešle své uzdravení
to be.
Jestli nám bude strašně hlavno. Nebo na ty vrchový tady na mě mám tady. A tady mám, že mě tam tady je to, že mě to já a tam mám, že mě mám to
Thank you. Thank you.
Teď se požehná taky Charles.